Capgemini, one of the top IT services vendors in Europe and the world's foremost provider of consulting, technology, and outsourcing services, celebrates this year its 50th anniversary. Today, the group announces the results for the first half of 2017. Paul Hermelin, hello.
Hello.
You are the chairman and CEO of Capgemini. What are the highlights of these first half results?
Quite pleased with the second quarter, consequently the first full half year of 2017. The momentum that we saw starting in the first quarter has amplified in the second quarter. Thus, our growth has a little bit increased. We deliver 3% constant currency growth, which is our guideline for the year, with a little better in the second quarter. Another acceleration of digital and cloud, so the new service lines that now represent 35% over the first half and even 37% in the second quarter. The acceleration of our margin as we promised it, and a good cash flow, so a solid first half.
As you just mentioned, you've guided towards 3% revenue growth this year. You've also guided for 11.7 to 11.9% margin, as well as free cash flow exceeding 950 million euros. So my question is, what is driving this projected revenue growth, and how are you achieving these targets?
So the growth comes first from Europe. Europe is very solid, the demand is strong, and we are doing well. We have a double-digit growth in Germany, in Italy, in Sweden. So we have really some engine for growth in Europe, and the demand remains very strong. The US, we are improving. We are back to positive figure, and we expect that to accelerate a little bit. And emerging country, let's say Asia-Pacific, solid. Latin America still under question with the Brazilian question. But I would just say, overall, the picture is solid, the demand for new service is there, and we managed to gain a little share on traditional services.
What can you tell us about your portfolio rotation to cloud and digital solutions?
My definition of digital is a little simplistic. It's the technology when it's bought by the business, no longer by the IT department. Actually, the IT department supports that effort. So, overall, now we say 37%. This is now a big share of the group revenue, and it's growing 21%, so it's booming. So what do we see? First, as we saw initially, these are the new customer service, the new customer experience, the journey with digital marketing, the support for digital channel. This is moving very fast. We have seen now the emergence of a second digital pillar, which is digital manufacturing. So it is the production, the supply chain. We do well. We made acquisition. We have reinforced our service line. We have won some beautiful deal with very first class logo, be it in banking or in retail. So we are doing pretty well. And I think the group is really one of the leaders there.
At your full year results presentation, you indicated that your top priority for 2017 was to resume strong organic growth in North America, possibly through further digital acquisitions. Given the issues we're facing in energy and utilities over there, what progress are you making?
So if you remember, we ended last year on a little poor growth, actually decline. We were still slightly in the red in Q1, minus 0.2. We have reached now plus one in Q2, so we are back to black figures. We can today say we aim for the third quarter 2.5, which confirms our promise of February, trending towards mid-single digit by year end, so the US will be back.
And what is your outlook for business growth in the rest of the world?
Today, as I said, we still bet on a strong Europe and the same geographies. In terms of sectors, we see a strong demand in financial service. Whatever some competitors say, it's solid. Good demand in manufacturing and the return of consumer product and retail. So at the end, this is enough to fuel a good growth.
What is your outlook regarding Brexit? Could there also be a business upside, as companies may need IT updates to handle Britain's departure from the EU?
So today, we are positive and nicely positive on the private sector, which is a little bit against what everybody predicted a year ago. But I would just say we start to see a little bit of wait and see in retail. So far, it has not impacted us, but we remain prudent for the second part of the year.
We've spoken about growth, but in a demanding environment, competitiveness is also key. What progress are you making?
So we should think of the group as a kind of two-side story. We have the buoyant new digital and cloud, and the rest, we have some volume growth, but some real tough demand from client on productivity and price. So we must fuel our productivity with energetic decision about automation and strong pyramid management, resource supply chain, a lot of effort on our people. So it's difficult because we manage a group where 37% of the group is really on a booming market where it's about recruitment and growth, and a little more than 60% of the group is fighting for productivity, but that's the market today.
And finally, in addition to your four recent bolt-on acquisitions, what further M&A activity might you pursue?
So you saw that we acquired four companies in Q1. In Q2, we have looked a little bit at larger entities. My view, they were not truly digital. So it was a little bit digital paint on the cover. So we are back on focusing, and we will announce soon a few additional small focused but very high-end digital entities.
Paul Hermelin, Chairman and CEO of Capgemini, thank you very much.
Thank you.